Congressman, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Forgive my voice cracking a little bit, but the adrenaline and emotion is still high. I was on deck about to hit batting practice on the third base side of home plate, and I hear a loud bam. And I look around, and behind third base and the third base dugout, which is cinder block, I see a rifle. And I see a little bit of a body, and then I hear another blam, and I realize that there's an active shooter. At the same time, I hear Steve Scalise over near second base scream. He was shot. He's our majority whip. You can imagine all the people in the field scatter. I run around to the first base side of home plate, and we have a batting cage that's got plastic wrapped around it to stop foul balls, and hide behind the plastic. Heard a break in the gunfire and decided to take a chance. Ran from home plate to the first base dugout. There were a number of congressmen and congressional staffers who helped us lying on the ground. One of them was wounded. Myself and another congressman, I don't remember who, applied a tourniquet to try to slow down the bleeding. And then, boom, about 5 feet from my head, I hear another shot. I did not know if it was a second shooter until I saw that it was one of our security detail, and he was ordering us to stay down. Another security detail person was closer to home plate, and there must have been 50 to 100 shots fired. The shooter starts coming around the home plate towards we are outside the fence line, and my understanding is that's where our security detail, maybe some of the ones who were wounded, still defending us, took him down. Once we got the all clear that the shooter was down, we ran out to second base for Steve Scalise. He had crawled into the outfield with leaving a trail of blood. I put pressure on his wound in his hip, and Brad Winstrip, congressman from Ohio, Cincinnati, fortunately he's a physician, he started doing what you need to do to try to minimize the blood loss.